got a nice backpack that he stole from the police.
LG. LG. LG.
Got a nice backpack that he stole from the police.
It's my motherfucking nigga LG on the motherfucking boards, case you're wondering. We doing this shit. Hell motherfucking yeah.
For the people that are not really known about you or not really familiar with you, can you do a little introduction about yourself?
Yeah, well, I mean, I did a lot of production in the mid and to late 90s. I did a group called LL Scratch. I did pretty much their whole project. I also did a group that's big in France called Supreme NTM. I did a lot of work with those guys. I did work with Big Daddy Kane, Positive K, Dave Hollister, Brian McKnight, a lot of different people. Big Al, Melee Sparks, BB Blacks, a lot of hip hop stuff. I mean, I can't even remember it all. Boogie Monsters, just a lot of stuff, man. A whole lot of different stuff. And I ended up linking up with Pac in 94. Because my brother was working on this project. My brother's Easy Mo P.
Yeah. Dope producer as well.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. So they had just did Temptations the night before. A partner that was in my brother's group, he had a group called Rapping is Fundamental, the guy AB Money, he came and let me hear Temptations. I was like, yo, that's crazy. And he was like, yo, we going back up there to see Pac today. He's like, yo, you should bring some beats. I came up there with him and brought some beats, and the Out on Bell beat was the first beat that came on, and he went crazy. He put it in the radio, and he was out. He just bounced to the bathroom like, I'm going to write this right now. And that was it. We was in the studio that night doing it.
So that's how Out on Bell was recorded?
Yeah, that's basically how I went there. And we went in there that night, and that's how Pac was. He recorded his vocals one take.
Mm-hmm.
He'd do one take for the main vocal, and he'd do his backgrounds, another one take, that's it. He was just good like that.
And do you have any memories about the studio session of the song?
Yeah, well, that night, I mean, it was just a lot going on, man. I mean, that's just how Pac was. That's for him, he had a lot of energy, and to keep that energy going, he kept it going, he kept a lot of trees going, a lot of liquor, that was Pac. He never stopped.
Mm-hmm.
He just never slept, That night, that same night, he did Straight Balling that same night. I think he did a good 3 or 4 of the records that same night. He just never stopped. He was always making records.
And was Pac just released from jail? I think at that time he was on jail for 15 days for having a fight with the Hughes brothers or something like that?
Just came back from, because that's when he had shot the cops. And they, but he didn't know they were cops, but they ran up on him and he ended up shooting the cop in the ass. And he got locked up for that down there, and he just came back and heard the beat and started making a song about it. And he was staying in that hotel. That was the hotel where everything went down with that girl, the Parker Meridian. So he was right. That's the hotel we went to see him at. Everything went down from there. He was like, yeah, I'm going to make a song about them cops. I was like, oh, that's what's up, man.
And can you remember who's doing the hooks on Out on Bell?
Oh, the group that's doing the hook, that's my brother group, Rapping is Fundamental. Numbers was Easy Mo B, AB Money, and JR. That was three group members, and they were singing the hook.
So Easy Mo B is singing on the hook as well?
Oh, yeah, all three of them. It's just the record. It was supposed to be on Me Against the World, and at the last minute, it didn't make the album.
And what is the reason for that?
Who knows? He had 1,000,001 songs. At that point, he was already locked up. So it was all kind of decisions being made, and he didn't have nothing to do with it. So the song just didn't make the album because he was in love with the song. That's why he performed it at the Source Awards.
Yeah, amazing live performance.
Yeah, he was. That was incredible because they was there for that too. They performed with him, and that was a big thing because he had cut Q-Tip off while Q-Tip was presenting or something like that. He just cut them off and started performing. And he was upset about that, but I mean, there wasn't nothing they could do about it at that point.
And what is the reason that he was throwing with his mic at the end of the song?
Well, because at that time, I mean, Pac was kind of different from anybody else on the West Coast, because everybody loved him here too, but that whole West Coast thing was kind of starting, and it was certain people that was kind of acting funny. But I think that was more from the fact that he came on and cut off Q-Tip and them like that. A lot of people really didn't like that, and he saw that, but he kept performing anyway. And that's why, you know, he had that attitude, and he just threw the mic down. Like, you know, he didn't care anyway.
Did Tupac know that he just did a show in the middle of someone else?
Yeah, he did it on purpose, because my brother Boot was with him. He was backstage with him, and while he was talking, he was like, look, man, let's do this. And he was just ready to set it off.
Do you know what the reason was for that?
I mean, just that's just Pac, man. He was ready to
Controversy,
go.
Controversy, a little bit.
Exactly. He was ready to go, so it's time to go. That's it.
And you said that the song was originally done for Me Against the World, right?
Yeah, it was.
A lot of people think that this is a song that was done for Turk Life, so that's not true.
Oh, no. It had nothing to do with that. It was done for Me Against the World. It was supposed to be on that album. And it just didn't make it. It was, Thug Life was never, I never heard nothing about that. Because Straight Ballin' was for Thug Life.
Yeah.
And that song was made for that.
Basically, he was recording two albums at the same time. Like you said, he recorded Straight Balling at the same night as Out on Bill.
Yeah, he recorded there, and then the next night he did the Running from the Police with Stretch and Dig.
Wow.
He was recording a million songs every day. He wouldn't stop.
Yeah, that's crazy.
He was real with that. Just put it up. You know, you can fix it later. Just put it up. We're going to do a song, and we do whatever we're going to do with it later. Never stop.
And there are a few versions of the original version of Out on Bill available on the internet. Did you ever hear them back?
No, I've never heard that. I only heard the original mix. Because when people also don't know, Easy Mo B mixed the record.
Okay, so Easy Mo B engineered the song.
Yeah, well, he mixed the record. He did all of the mutes to it.
Okay.
He did all the mute, all the drops and everything. He arranged the record as far as, you know, mixing.
Did Tupac record any vocals that were not used on your mixdown of the song Out on Bill?
No. I'm straight up with you. And pretty much everything, every vocal that I was there and witnessed him do was a one take. He did one take, and then he went over it and did his second take because he liked doing doubles, and that was it. There's no other vocals.
Wow.
That was it. You know, he was just good like that, and that'd be the final vocal.
No, that's great.
No, like he did an alternate version or something like that. Nah, not at all. I wish.